Sailboats of the Desert are specially found in Death Valley. We're going to learn about it in details within the next few minutes. So welcome to the Space, Earth and Ocean Sciences, and stay tuned till the end. Death Valley, an extremely hot region located 282 feet below the sea levels in the state of California in USA, is famous for its immense breathtaking landscapes of high mountain chains, canyons, sand dunes, craters, and many more geological features. The oldest rock dating back to 1.7 billion years, but the valley took its current shape just 3 million years back by the development of faults along which the blocks of the mountain moved past each other and formed alternate valley and mountain ranges. Majorly, the composition of rock here are limestone and sandstone, but igneous and metamorphic rocks are also present in rich amounts. The valley is continuously carving out through weathering and erosional processes, and it is highly desired for tourism and scientific purposes. From the last 30 years, experts were trying to solve a mystery in this region that confuses, horrifies, and excites everyone. Yes, these mysteriously self-moving rocks that leaves the trails of movement behind them are also the part of this Death Valley. People were noticing them since long back in history, but no one has ever caught them moving. People got confused about how these rocks are moving by itself, as there were no visible forces for them to recognize. And these rocks are called the sailboats of the desert. Scientists took this geological phenomenon into consideration in the year of 1990. Various papers were published then mentioning the reason behind this self-movement, like heavy storms is pushing these rocks ahead. Magnetic phenomena is acting over these rocks. Also, these rocks are slipping over this wet, slippery, soft soil over which they are lying. But none of them were able to collect the concrete evidences supporting their hypothesis. Various observations were made and tried to collect the evidences by setting cameras, recording time lapses, but they failed again. No one traced any movement of rocks because these rocks move very rarely, and that's extremely hard to catch that in camera. Region where these rocks lie or move is a dry lake in the northwestern side of the Death Valley. During the heavy storms, this region temporarily fills up with water. The size of the boulder range from 15 to 46 centimeters in diameter, weighing up to 700 pounds. Many times experts have found that lightweight, small-sized rock got displaced in storms, but did not form any trails behind. That similar storm didn't even touch the heavyweight rocks. So definitely, wind is not playing any role here. For the next 20 years, no one had any clue about this. Then in 2014, this geological phenomena got its mystery solved by the team of scientists from Scripps Institute of Oceanography. What they have done is installed a GPS device in the rocks that are exactly similar to these moving rocks, as original rock deformation was not allowed by the valley authorities, and put those samples in that lake in the year of 2011. They visited that experiment site again in the winters of December 2013. They observed what has shocked them. They found out a rare combination of events that is necessary to carry out this rare movement. They explained, in the winter night, when temperature lowers, the lake fills up with water deep enough to froze into very thin windowpane-like ice sheets less than 5 mm in size, but has lot of strength. Also, the water levels needed to be shallow enough in order to expose the rocks above the ice. The following day must be a sunny day, having warm and humid weather to break the ice sheets into several plates. Presence of wind of speed 3 to 4 meters per second is also necessary in order to float these broken ice panels over the slippery, wet and soft mud. When this wind moves the ice panels, it glides the rock in their way against the friction offered by the wet land, marking the traces of movement on land. This combination of event is rare, and any more or less in the amounts of water, ice, winds or temperature can really make the big difference in the outcome. They also recorded the time of motion of rocks. Each rock on an average moves for a few seconds to 15 minutes depending upon the ice sheets that is pushing them. And it's hard to point out the movement of rocks in this large desert where all the rocks are moving. After all, we need a reference point to identify any motion. So in this extremely heated desert, ironically, only this thin ice is able to move these heavy rocks. And with this successful experiment, the long back mystery got solved. This dry flat region or lake in the desert is called Playa. This term is related to area where water stays for a very short period of time. Either it percolates into groundwater or evaporates into the atmosphere. These moving rocks creates a sort of racetrack-like design behind them, so this region is particularly called as racetrack playa. These cracks are called the mud cracks, formed when moisture from the upper layer of soil evaporates and layer shrinks while lower layer remains moistured. This difference creates a strain and forms the cracks of polygonal shapes. Tune into our channel by subscribing. We keep on uploading videos on such interesting topics of space, earth and oceans. And click out these videos popping on your screen. I'll see you with another new video.